Good morning. Welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Church of Tippecanoe County. My name is Kim Harden, and I'm a member of the Worship Committee. Whether you are a member or a first-time visitor, we welcome you. Regardless of whom you love, we welcome you. Before our service, we have a few announcements to share. Please join us for conversation and fellowship following the service in the same Zoom room. If you would like to learn more about our church or denomination, please go to our website, uuctc.org. Our board for this congregation is meeting Tuesday evening at 6:30 on June 15th. On June 30th at 7 p.m., the film Moonlight will be shown on Zoom. It is part of our summerish film festival. On Friday mornings, UUCTC hosts the Westside Lum Food Pantry from 10 until noon. Let our service begin.
It is said that ministers are here to comfort the afflicted and afflict the comfortable. I say we are all afflicted, and we are all comfortable. May our time together this morning be a comfort and a confrontation. May we here find peace in times of tumult. May we here invite tumult into lives of peace. May we here find calm in times of restlessness. May we here allow restlessness to evolve into action. Let this be the place you consider what you've never considered. Let this be the place you imagine for yourself, something new and unthinkable. May this hour bring dreams of new ways of being in the world. Come, let us worship together. Sharon Wiley. If ever there were a time for a candle in the darkness, this would be it. Using a spark of hope, kindle the flame of love. Ignite the light of peace and feed this flame of justice. Melanie Davis. The words of our covenant can be found in the chat box and in your order of service. Love is the spirit of this church and service is its law, to dwell together in peace, to seek the truth in love, and to help one another.
This song is titled, When Our Heart is in a Holy Place, so please join us in singing.
When we trust the wisdom in each of us, by John Lennon, a member of the Beatles, and it's called Imagine. Again, I'm putting the lyrics in the chat box, and so please join me while we sing this song together.
Each of us has gifts to share: our time, talent, thoughtfulness, financial resources. Let us open our hearts and give freely and gladly. If you use the Square website during the service, your gift will be shared with our June Change for Change recipient, the Free Baby Pantry, a community program of the Second Baptist Church in Lafayette. To contribute after the service, please go to our website, uuctc.org, and click on the Give button in the upper right-hand corner. You may also send checks to the church. Thank you for giving generously.
Yeah. wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops, that's where
question I've come across is this. If you get to have a gay pride month, then why can't we have a straight pride month? My response, you get the other 11 months of the year where you don't have to question your safety just because of who you love. You don't have to worry about hate crimes or violence against you. You don't have to worry about riots and police singling you out because you're transgender, and then having to defend yourself with a brick. You don't have to worry about being harassed at a public pool for being gay, even at the age of 11, and then those bullies throwing a basketball at you over and over. You don't have to worry about holding hands with your significant other in public or elsewhere. You were never in a closet that you had to judge the safety of coming out of, even to your parents and family. You don't have to worry about losing the love and support that is supposed to be unconditional. You've never been told that you're too young to know who you love, or asked when you chose to be gay. When did you know that you were straight? When did you choose to be straight? It's love. I believe that love is more than merely a power that claims us. It is also a power that we claim by choosing our response to the truth of our world. To love can be a choice, whether we are at the bedside of a loved one dying or at the side of a stranger we have only just met. The love which inspires the courage and commitment of such choices. It's not a sweet or sentimental kind of love. Rather, it's a love which recognizes the greater good and the bonds of kinship. Those bonds which we are all a part. But once we accept love, not just as an emotion, but as a choice, then we must also come to terms with where that choice leads us. Love cannot be just for one or some of us. If it is for any of us, it must be for all of us. Love cannot be just for those with loud voices, but must also be for the voiceless. Love cannot be just for those with power, but also for those who are marginalized. Love cannot be just for those who still hope, but also for those who despair that help and hope will never come. So take a moment to reflect on this particular time in your own life, in the lives of your family and friends, and in the state of our community, our world. Who needs us to side with them in love? To answer that call of love? What moral questions does our commitment to love as this church community, what does that call us to address in this coming year? I don't have the answers, nor are the choices only mine to make. But I lift up these questions to spark a conversation as individual people who care about this world as a community of faith, hope, social justice, and most of all, unconditional love.
Following the service, we will have a 5-minute break and then return to the same Zoom room for conversation and fellowship. Hope to see you there.
When I say go in peace, I don't mean go in mindless oblivion. When I say go in peace, I don't mean go without challenging yourself or others. When I say go in peace, I don't mean go in utter ease and comfort. When I say go in peace, I mean go in peace seeking justice. I mean go in peace committed to equal rights and opportunities for all. When I say go in peace, I mean go in the peace that is created when together we build communities of true solidarity, deep compassion, and fierce, unrelenting love. Go in peace. Jim McGaw.
If you're gay, then you're gay. Don't pretend that you're straight. You could be who you are any day of the week. You are unlike the others, so strong and unique. We're all with you. If you're straight, well, that's great. You can help procreate and make gay little babies for the whole human race. Make a world we can live in where the one who you love's not an issue. 'Cause we're all somewhere in the middle. We're all just looking for love to change the world. But if the world stops spinning tomorrow, you can't keep running away from who we are. If you're gay, then you're gay. If you're straight, well, that's great.